Hi guys, and welcome to Ignite. We're back again. It's darker outside, it's colder. Luce, we've been doing this through since, it's been like two seasons now. We've gone all the way through summer.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've gone all the way through autumn and nobody can tell me it's not winter. It is freezing.
It's so cold.
It's gone from us complaining that it's too hot to being absolutely freezing cold. But we're so glad that you guys keep coming to hang out with us. We love spending time with you all. And today, I know that Lucy has a great devotion to share with us. They're always fantastic. Mm-hmm. And I'm still not over the fact that God wants to speak to us. So Lucy, do you want to tell us what God has been saying to you since the last time we spoke?
Yes, I would love to. Now, like Deb, I have gone off the Psalms and gone into a different book of the Bible because I thought, you know what? I love the Psalms, but there is so much more in the Bible to talk about. And there
Definitely.
Is one verse which I know that you will know, Deb, because it's one of the most well-known verses of the Bible. It is Jeremiah 29:11.
Come on.
Yeah. I haven't just gone with the verse 11. I've gone for a few verses afterwards as well.
12 and 13. They don't normally get a shout out, 12 and 13.
Exactly. But they are good to know. They are good to know. So, It says this. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. In those days when you pray, I will listen. If you look for me wholeheartedly, you will find me. Isn't that an awesome verse?
You could just stop there, like just literally close the Bible.
Stop. But yeah, so I thought to make it easy to remember, I've got 2 points. So my first point is God has a plan, plain and simple.
Yes.
It says, God says these words, for I know the plans I have for you. He actually says that. It is in speech marks and it says
That's
the Lord
nuts,
says.
Isn't it?
It is nuts. And I don't know about you, Deb, but I can sometimes have a mini freak out because I'm a little bit out of control, because I'm like, I don't know what I'm going to do next with my life.
Like you feel like you don't have a plan.
Yeah, but that's okay. Like we don't need to be in control because God is in control.
No,
and
he's
already told us he has a plan for us. And you know what's even better, Deb? It's a plan that is good and is not going to harm us. Isn't that?
You can't really lose, can you? Like
you
not only does he have a plan, it's a good plan.
It's a win-win. situation. So that's my first
point.
And then the second one is we will find him. It says, in those days when you pray, I will listen. If you look for me wholeheartedly, you will find me. So obviously we don't physically see God. We can't.
No, we don't. Yeah.
God. However, because we have faith and we believe that God is real and that Jesus came to earth and died for us.
Absolutely.
So we can be saved and have eternal life. Even though we don't physically see them, but one day we will go to heaven and we will see Jesus. We will. But we feel their presence, which sounds very weird, doesn't it, Deb?
It's weird, isn't it? Yeah, but it's true.
But it's something so hard to explain, but something so amazing at the same time. So when we seek him wholeheartedly, we will find him. So to do that, we can do three things that I can think of off the top of my head. We can pray, read the Bible, and worship. Now, I love worship, and I know that you do.
Oh, I love a bit of worship, me, Luce.
And in those times of worship, when we've got music on, and I really feel very close to God in those times.
Yeah, me too.
There's no denying that God is real, especially in those times for me. Obviously, for other people, it can be when they pray. I mean, I'm not saying I don't feel God's presence in all these.
But that's when you feel him the most.
But I feel him the most in worship,
yeah.
And everyone has their own way of connecting with God more than others. So it's God is amazing how he connects to everybody because he knows everybody so well. So when we do these things, and I'm sure you guys can probably think of other things to do as well, but we will find him when we seek him wholeheartedly. So we have to actually seek him. So I know that if I want my mum, I won't sit there and just be like...
Just waiting.
I'll be like, okay, mom, like, I need you.
Exactly.
You help me. You'll ring, you'll give them a text. Like, you'll do something to find.
Yeah, absolutely. That's such a good point. It is.
You know what I mean? That is what we do with God. We pray to him. That's how we talk to God. And we read his word and worship. So our 2 points were God has a plan and we will find him. And that is enough said, to be honest.
That's so good. It's so practical. Yeah. I'm going to remember that now. Like, if I want my mum, I don't just wander around and hope she knows. Do you know what I mean? Like, I text her and I call my mum about everything. So I call her to ask her, like when I don't know something, when I do know something, if I've seen a really big tree, I call my mum for everything. You know what I mean? So if I can do that with my mum, why can't I do that with God? Who God is easier to reach, by the way, than my mum, because she doesn't ask.
Literally. God, you just have to speak and he's there, he's listening, because he loves us that much. So yeah.
Oh, Liz, that is fab. I love that.
Yeah. So
great work.
I hope that's been encouraging. Now I'm going to hand over to you, Deb, for our second part of question week.
Yes, that's question week. It's sort of a lockdown question week, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I was really encouraged by the questions that you asked me last time, Luce, because I hadn't actually thought about like what I'd learned in lockdown and how I'd improved as a human being. And it really encouraged me. I was like, well, that hasn't been a waste. It's actually been all right, hasn't it? Like, that's what I was thinking
about. Exactly.
So I've got four lockdown questions for you. Four.
How exciting.
Okay. Right. Yeah. And kids, this is so good. You can ask yourself these questions. You can say, all right, how have I changed from the beginning? Does my family look different? Like, it's so good to see your progress. So I like it. Good job, Luce. So, the first question is what you asked me. What skill have you learned in lockdown? You have learned this. You've learned lots of skills, so don't you dare.
You know what? Weirdly, one of the biggest things I've learned is how to edit videos, Deb.
I was going to say, if you don't say anything, that's what I'm going to say.
I never thought, like, when I signed up to be the kids pastor at Breed, that I would be editing videos to go on YouTube, in all honesty.
It's mad, isn't it?
But here we are in 2020 and the unimaginable things have happened. So that's the biggest thing,
That's amazing. Like, do you think, because obviously God knows everything and he knew it was going to be super hard for us, but how kind is he that he's like, all right, while they have to deal with this, you can learn how to do this, and you can learn how to do this. So now, even after the pandemic, right, even afterwards, you've still got that skill.
Exactly, which means we can carry on doing it. Yeah, for anyone that misses. So yeah.
Exactly. Okay, Luce. Question two is what we're on. Right, and I loved your answer to question one, because God has just given us all new gifts and all new skills in this time that's been pretty pants, hasn't he? So that's so good. Okay, question two. What was the hardest thing for you about lockdown? Because now we're in lockdown two, it's all a bit different, but the first lockdown, what was the hardest thing for you?
Honestly, the hardest thing for me was not being able to see people other than my family. Obviously, I've been very blessed that I'm not living on my own and I've got my family here with me. But it's kind of like, it's not even like your freedom's been taken away, but it felt like
your freedom was
taken away and you couldn't just go out and we didn't even go out in the car because we were told we were going to get fined and you could go for a walk like once a day. But I think that was definitely the hardest part for me, was not being able to see people, because I'm a people person. I like to be around people, and I like I like to go and see my friends and everyone, and you couldn't even see your family at the time.
No, I couldn't see my mum.
Exactly, and just little things that you take for granted, like just being able to go out and just go nip to see your nan or go see your friends just for a drink. Like, you couldn't do that, and that was really hard for me. I didn't like
it. It was really hard.
Yeah. But that's good.
Sometimes it's good to recognise and talk about the things that you find hard, because they're easier now, but at the beginning, it was horrible.
It was awful. It really was horrible. Yeah. But yeah.
Okay, so let's cheer it up a bit. That was a bit of a sad question. Let's cheer it up. What is your best lockdown memory? Like, what's the best thing that happened for you in lockdown? Like, the thing that you'll remember forever?
Do you know what? This is so ridiculous, but me and my sister, because I'm not on TikTok. I'm going to be honest. I'm not on, because I know that if I was on, it would take hours away of my life, and I do not want that. But Emma, my sister, is, and she was like, come do these dances with me. And you know what, Deb?
Aww.
Pretty proud of each other. If we can possibly put one of the dances in this video, it would be...
Oh, please do. Oh, I want to see it so bad. Please do.
Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross. Cha-cha, real smooth.
We we did a few, and we were really peeing ourselves laughing. And the weather was so nice. It was just we were outside in our shorts and our t-shirts, and that was one of the. I think because it was so funny, that was one of my favourite memories. Takeaway was making silly dances up with my sister.
Because Luce, if you guys were allowed out, to be honest, you probably wouldn't have been together doing dances together if it was normal. Not. So that's a memory that you've had because of lockdown. So that's really that's really good. Okay, last question. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
This is the hardest question.
Oh, great.
Listen to the wording, right? What has lockdown taught you about Jesus?
Oh, okay. You know what? There's more than one thing, I suppose, really, in that question.
Yeah, there is.
But you know what? The biggest thing I've learned about Jesus is that he is in control.
Yeah.
I did know that, but I think because... I mean, my life's pretty fine and dandy, but to be thrown so deep out into the water that lockdown was, and not knowing what was going on, and it's like one of the things that I struggle with is being in control, because I like to know what's going on.
Yeah, me too. I enjoy knowing what's happening next. Yeah.
Me too. But because we didn't, I had to really rely on Jesus and trust that he was in control of what was going on. Like Jeremiah 29:11, he has a plan for us.
The plan, this plan, yeah.
Yeah, and it's not to harm us, so I had to really focus and fix my eyes upon Jesus and know that he was in control. So I suppose the biggest thing that I did learn was to trust him, and that he was faithful, and he is faithful, he is trustworthy, and knowing that it wouldn't last forever because of who God is. So I think that's the biggest thing. And I mean, just to add on, also that, you know, he's always there and he cares and he does listen. Because there's so many times I'd be like, oh, I don't know what to do, and have a little bit. And then it was like, I just felt at peace because, you know, he listens to you and he cares, so he's going to.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
That's fantastic, Luce. Luce, those are fantastic answers. And I think it's really important, especially that while we're filming this, we're halfway through the second one.
Yeah.
Which is mad already, isn't it?
It's crazy.
It's really important to just think how far we've actually come and what have we learned. It hasn't been a waste of time. It felt like a waste of time at times.
Yeah.
But it really hasn't been. And I think last week talking about it and this week talking about it has really shown we've actually learned so much.
Yeah, definitely.
So,
definitely.
I love that, Luce. Well done. Good answering.
Thank you for that. That was fun. And like we say, you can do this at home. You can reflect and think about things. It is really good to write things down and remember, because then you can look back when you're in another situation that could be similar and think, well, you know what? God got me through that, so he's going to get me through this. So yeah, that's something
love
that
it, Luce.
All do.
Love it. But good job.
It has come to the end of our Ignite already. It goes so fast because we just have so
fast. Much.
Yeah, but we will be back next week for more fun and games and another awesome devotion from Deb. So we hope you all have the best week. Remember to stay safe and keep washing your hands. And
keep those hands clean. These are the cleanest our hands have ever been. I think we always should have been washing our hands, but I'm glad everybody wants us to now. So keep washing them, kids. We love you.
We do. And we will see you all next Friday. Bye.
Okay. Take care. Bye.
Bye.